This is Mike with my Real Estate Dojo with Mr. Investor. And gang, I hear this question a lot from my mentoring students. And the question goes something like this. When do you think I could quit my job? How much money do you think I can make in this business? How many deals do you think I can do a month? So I want to take this time to make a video to help everybody understand what are you guys are up to, what are you against. Now, I'm a very, very positive guy. I definitely believe every one of you guys have greatness in you. We live in the best country called America, and you come from the very bottom, like myself, and a refugee to America, didn't speak the language, to go wherever you want to go through hard work, to burning desire, through education, to drive, through commitment, through sacrifice, etc. Okay? But I want to be realistic with you guys, okay? Being a business owner, being an investor is extremely, extremely hard. And I'm going to go ahead and give you a couple of ideas why I'm saying this. I'm not trying to be negative, okay? Number one is that you guys know this chart is called the Rich Dad Cash Flow Quadrant. You have the E, the S, the B, the I. If you guys don't know what this is, go ahead and watch my videos about the four books I recommend to read, okay? So a lot of my students that come to me are in this quadrant, which means that you have a job, okay? Now, and so if, when you ask me the question, well, how many deals can I do? When can I quit my job with the man and have my own business, okay? I always tell them it's extremely hard because you're in this quadrant, you're trying to bypass this quadrant, you're trying to bypass this quadrant, and you're trying to get right into investing, okay? That is an extremely hard process to do. It's kind of like climbing Mount Everest, and you never hiked in your life before, you never climbed a mountain before, okay? And here's the reasons why I'm telling you this, because when you're in your E quadrant, you have certain types of skills, and you have certain types of responsibilities and liabilities, okay, and certain type of mindset. Whenever you come to the S quadrant, you have to learn different types of skills, different types of sales, negotiation, liabilities, responsibilities, etc. When you go to the B, again, you have to learn a bunch of new stuff. More importantly, you have to change yourself even more from the E than the S. And when you go from the B to the I, the same thing happens, but there's more learning, more responsibility, more liabilities, more changing inside of you, okay? So all this stuff should take many, many years because for me, I had a job, I was self-employed, I started a business, created systems, then I got into the I. So it took me a long time, and I'm still in the process of going through the journey, guys. So a lot of the students that contact me, they're in the E and they want to come here, and I don't want to tell you it's an easy job. No, it's not. I'm not selling anything to you, no books, no CDs, or any seminars. So I want to be realistic with you. I want to shoot straight with you. This is a very hard journey. Now, is it possible? Absolutely. You know, the odds are 99% against you, okay? You have only 1% realistically to make it. It's called the underdog. But guys, the grass is so green here. You can do it if you're willing to hustle, if you're willing to bustle. You got to sacrifice, you know? A lot of times I talk about sacrifice and people don't know what sacrifice is. You know, they think they know what it is. Sacrifice is not doing the things you really love. Not like, but love. Like, I love to hang out with my kids. I love to see my family. I love to watch this, my favorite show. Whatever you love, I love to play music. I love to work out. Whatever it is, you got to be able to let that go to gain something that's better. And you're the only one that's going to know if your why to let go of this stuff is worth all that. And so when you ask me that question, how long would it take for me to retire? It just makes me crack up because A, I don't have a crystal ball. Two, I don't know what kind of commitment you have between your ears. I don't know what your why is. I don't know how hard you want to work. Another point is that commitment. Commitment means that you're gonna do whatever fuck it takes. Let me say that again. You're gonna do whatever fuck it takes to make it happen for you. If that means no sleeping, if that means no TV, if that means no vacation, not spending time with your family, if that means not doing stuff you like, if that means not doing stuff you love, if that means going facing your fears, if that means going learning new stuff, if that means, you know, having people diss on you, if that means people telling you no, if that means making 100 phone calls, if that means making 300 phone calls, if that means not eating, if that means whatever, whatever the fuck it takes, if you're willing to do that, then you're gonna have success. So that's all from heart. You can be small or big. You can be skinny or fat. You can be white or black. You could be a loser or a winner. You could be smart or dumb. And I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. All it takes is heart, guys. If you have the heart, then you'll be successful. So that's only determined by you. My heart comes from my commitments, my why. I'm never going to quit. I'm never going to give up. I'm never going to quit. I'm never going to give up. And that mental attitude is what defines me from the other gentlemen that are out there that are a lot smarter than me, that have better language skills than me, that have better connection, better support, better family. I don't give a fuck. And if you have that type of mental attitude, you'll be able to do it in America, okay? So to answer your question, it's extremely hard. You only have 1% chance of making it. But if your why is big enough, if you have good work ethics, then you can do anything in America. You can't do it in a lot of other countries. You couldn't do it in my country, Iran. That's why we had to escape our country, come to America, okay? So please take time and stop looking at all the negativity in life and look at the opportunity in life. Again, don't look at all the negativity in life, but look at the opportunities in life. If you're in the E quadrant and you want to get here, look at all the opportunities instead of negativities, okay? And that's what I'm trying to get to you. End of the day, in conclusion, it is hard, but it's not impossible. And if your will, if your heart is big enough, you're willing to work for it and never quit, you can do anything and everything in America. As long as you're alive, you're willing to fight for it, you can do it. Gang, if you like these videos, please comment. Please leave a message. Please like, please share. This is Mike with my Real Estate Dojo, and I'll talk to you later, gang.